In Chapter 4 of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, a year passes without incident. But then, a savage murder occurs. A young maidservant is looking out the window at the moon when she sees a white-haired gentleman and Hyde meet on the street outside. She recognizes Hyde because he had once visited her employer. The two men talk, and then Hyde suddenly beats the older man to death with his cane. The maid calls for help, but Hyde is gone when the police arrive. They find Carew's watch, money, and a letter addressed to Mr. Utterson on the dead body. When they take the letter to Mr. Utterson, he accompanies them to view the body. He identifies it as Sir Danvers Carew, a respected gentleman and a client of Utterson's. Utterson then guides the police to Hyde's home, located in a disreputable part of town. Hyde's villainous-looking maid lets the men in, but informs them that Hyde is not home. Utterson and the police inspector search the house and find that Hyde uses only two rooms, leaving the rest of the house empty. Those rooms, though expensively furnished, are in a chaotic state, as if ransacked, and a number of partially burned papers sit by the fireplace. They find the murder weapon, the broken cane, and the burned remains of Hyde's checkbook. They then visit Hyde's bank and find that he still has thousands of pounds there. This encourages the police inspector, who thinks that he is sure to come get the money. In the days and weeks that follow, no sign of Hyde turns up. He has no family, no friends, nobody who's seen him can describe his appearance as anything but evil. The murder is the main event in this chapter, with Stevenson signaling possible interpretations. The description of the maidservant musing at the window is distinctly romantic. Dreaming of life's possibilities, Hyde's appearance turns the dream into a nightmare. It can be inferred that Hyde's interaction with Carew introduces a red herring. Though Stevenson does not say this, the interaction between the men suggests a homosexual encounter. Two men who seem to not know each other strike up a conversation in the middle of the night in a disreputable, lower-class neighborhood. This leads readers to speculate if this is the nature of Hyde's hold over Jekyll. Stevenson, however, quickly shows the situation must be more complicated. If Hyde is simply homosexual, he could have gone with the man. If Hyde's hold over Jekyll is blackmail about homosexual activity, he would have taken Carew's money. This chapter again further elaborates on the Gothic setting, a foggy neighborhood lit by moonlight where a peaceful interaction quickly turns violent. Lastly, Hyde's broken cane is symbolic of his identity as a gentleman. Its breaking symbolizes Hyde's no longer being able to pass freely in society, as he is a suspected murderer now.